Hello and welcome. I'm your host Rupesh Samant. Welcome on Hot Seat. We have John Fernandez with us. He's president of Goa Pradesh Congress Committee. He's a guy who is doing firefighting within and outside the party. He has been facing a lot of criticism within the party. We have seen many people lobbying against him, and still they are preparing for the Lok Sabha, supposedly unitedly. One question. Everyone says that you can't even win Sarpanch election, and why? How can John lead such a big party and such a big party organization in Goa?
No, I had no ambition of becoming that type of leader right from my childhood. I was a party worker. So I had many opportunities to fight election because I was the only general secretary in Goa Daman Diu Pradesh Congress Committee in 80s. At the peak of Indira Gandhi's popularity, and I was very close to Indiraji and to Sanjay Gandhi. So it was not difficult for me to get any seat and win any seat, because those days seats were not won on local popularity but on the national popularity. I never aspired to go and grab power. I have always been a worker.
No, but and you grabbed power and, later on and you became Rajya Sabha.
No. Yeah, listen to me. So even when Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi came to Goa, I was the General Secretary, we were looking out for a candidate for Raj Sabha. So I had proposed three names for the Raj Sabha because I knew that was a upper house. So first name I had proposed was Mr. Pandurang Mulgaonkar. The second name I had proposed was Dr. V.N. Mayengar. Third name I had proposed was Mr. Praful Piyolkar, senior congressman and freedom fighters. So when I met Rajiv Gandhi, when he came to Goa for inauguration of the statehood of Goa on 3rd of June, I put this name forward to him. Earlier I had put same name before the Home Minister who had come down in the morning, Mr. Panigrahi. And I had no ambition even to go to Raj Sabha because I never aspire for power, to get power and to be in the hot seat of governance. It was very easy for me to get it. As I told you earlier that I was very close to Indiraji, very close to Sanjay ji. Rajiv ji put it to me, why you want these old people? Why not you? Are you not eligible? I was the general secretary of the party here. And earlier I also was the youth congress president under him when he was the general secretary of AICC. So I was taken aback, I was taken by surprise. And that is how I landed in the topmost House of Parliament, okay, the upper house.
In this entire thing, you said I don't aspire for power. You don't aspire for power. Still, you are heading a party which aspires for power in center.
Certainly, I did not talk about my party. I said me personally.
No, but it has to be within you that there has to be a trait that I should win or my party should win. There should be some.
Right.
Motivation within.
No, there are selfless workers in the party, like many of them. They are not seen. They are you can call them the underground workers. Now, do you know who has set aside the regional plan of Goa? It is me, but nobody knows it. Because that was the biggest fraud which was perpetuated on the people of Goa.
By your own party?
Whoever it is, I am saying the regional plan. So, is my name anywhere in the press? So there are many workers who are underground workers who are doing excellent work for the state of Goa and for public propriety. So I think this is one of the example where you need not be seen from outside. Your name need not come in the paper. And this is not a surprise for me because I am the oldest congressman in this party, loyal congressman for 43 years. Worked in the party, and there is no person in Goa who is senior to me.
Okay, we'll come back to that.
Yeah.
Actually, when we talk about regional plan, we are indirectly talking about Babush Monserrat. We'll come to that.
No, I don't want to take any names. I'm saying the scheme as such. I'm not taking names. I have not opposed names. I have opposed that fraudulent plan.
Who planned
which,
it?
Which would have... No, if we go and debate on that point, then there won't be any end to it. Then we will be involved in, you know, calling names. I don't want to call names. I'm saying
you don't want to call names, or
that,
you don't want to
that
blame them.
That many works can be done without coming out, you know, and exposing yourself as a leader and a power grabber. I don't have that ambition. Still, I don't have that ambition.
There is a question mark whether you can be really a leader for Goa Congress. So how do
I am not a leader. That's why again you are making a mistake. I have not projected myself a leader. I have told my committee also that I am not a leader. I am a worker. I am called a president because I am presiding. Otherwise, I am a worker. I will continue to be a worker of the party.
So yours are similar to that Aam Aadmi Party?
No. I wouldn't say Aam Aadmi Party. I wouldn't compare me myself to them because I have done better work than these people. These people have come now in the market and they are just jumping like jacks. They only want a TV popularity and public gaze, that's all. But I have done work even as a member of parliament where contentious issues were raised, especially on environment. It is I who stopped the project of Tata project of housing across Mandovi Bridge by raising the issue in parliament.
That went to High Court and eventually High Court stopped it.
I am not controlling High Court and the Supreme Court.
But High Court stopped it later.
High Court had brought in a stay saying that that project is in forest area without a proper license. So I am saying I raised the issues. Aam Aadmi were not there. And also those people who are playing guitars around him, they were not there. They were sleeping.
You're talking about Remo?
I don't want to name any persons. So the second issue is that CBI was sanctioned for Goa, but they were not in Goa. They were kept in Bombay. It is at my personal request to Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi that the CBI was sent to Goa. They opened up an office in Goa. Subsequently, again I don't want to call name, the consent of CBI was withdrawn. I raised the issue in the parliament. I brought back CBI. And the CBI is functioning in Goa.
So basically you are correcting the mistakes of your own party. Your party was making mistakes.
I wouldn't go in the party when public issues are there. Party is not important to me. What is important to me? The state is important. Public is important. People are important.
No, the issue party is not party because of your
party. Party is there to serve the people. Party is not there to serve itself or its leaders.
No, but they were not precisely all these issues existed because your party policies were wrong. That's why your CBI office was.
They were not party policies were wrong. They were individual aberrations. Those were individual aberrations. Those were not party policies and programs. Party has not directed
them. Those individuals from where we.
Party never directed them to tell them, please pack up the CBI from Goa. It was done without even the cabinet decision. So how we can say these are policy decisions?
Even here, I don't want to name anyone.
I wouldn't name. People know it. Goa is too small. Everybody know everybody. Why
okay,
we should
these
name
are,
it?
These are the things of past. Now,
I'm saying vis-a-vis the Aam Aadmi Party, I raised this issue. Where were these people when I raised the issue? I raised the issue of kerosene being put in petrol by getting excess kerosene for Goa fraudulently. I raised the issue, demanded the CBI. Where were these people?
These are old issues. Now, coming back to current issues, how do you feel you are leading a party in Goa which is highly fragmented? People don't see eye to eye to each other. They are not bothered about each other. How do you react to that?
That is Congress. If it was one cohesive group, then it wouldn't be called a political party. That is Congress. And that is the beauty of Congress. Congress takes everybody, every shades of opinion, all individual with different ideas, ideas and, ethos together. Because Congress is like a ocean.
What is a beauty? Fighting amongst each other is a beauty.
It is a part of politics. And I like to fight.
So you all are playing politics?
Certainly. I'm a student of politics. I majored in politics.
Your politics is not towards society. Your politics is like we fight.
That is subsequently when you raise the issue of fighting, only by fighting you raise the issue, public issue. You fight out for those issues, for the public right. And that is what I call fighting.
Within your organization, they don't fight for public issues. They fight for their own issues.
I don't know about others, but as far as I am concerned, when I was in my party, I fought for those issues. For example, when there was an attempt to make Goa University into a central university, I fought for it. I said, there is only one university, Goans have it. Keep it that for Goa. If you want central university, you can start 10-20 on the Western Ghats. But not this issue. So, this is what is called fighting.
No, this is a different case. I am talking about current scenario wherein your own leaders are fighting amongst themselves. Not for public issues. I have not seen anyone fighting for public issues.
No, I don't see that they are fighting among themselves for no issues. I think maybe the issues are involved there. I don't think they are just taking the boxing gloves and, punching each other. That is not
issues
the case.
Issues are like who should be in GPCC, who should be CLP leader? These are the issues that have been
naturally there's fight for power, that's politics. Everybody wants to achieve one chair. There's only one chair of a PCC president. Now how many people wants it? There are dozens of people who want that chair. And it was a difficult choice to put me in that chair. They almost made study for 6 months, you know it, from July to December. So it was a very difficult choice.
How much time you will require to make peace with all these things?
There is no question of doing peace. There is no war. There is no war. The moment I start doing my work, so everybody will get just away from my path. Now they fight because they have no work. They are idle.
So you are giving them work.
Everybody will get work. All my general secretary, the other day I had, last Monday I had my first office bearers and executive committee meeting. I have 48 members. 42 members attended the meeting. 2 members abstained with consent. 4 members only abstained without consent. So it was an excellent meeting. It was a quiet interaction and we talked issue. And we talked how to create a CADA and how to rebuild the party. So that is what I am talking of talking. The talking of talking, how to strengthen the party. If you don't talk of strengthening the party to serve the people, then you talk some other talk which has no relevance.
They and talk that because is they have no other work.
They have no other work, therefore they talk something which is not relevant and then therefore they fight.
Yeah, you are going to give them work.
Yeah, we have already distributed. A general secretary and a secretary is in charge of 4 blocks, 4 assembly constituencies. My 2 vice presidents, lady vice presidents, are in charge of Mapsa district office. We have district office. And another lady vice president is in charge of Madgaon, South Goa district office.
Okay, these are organizational.
Organizational matters. So my office bearers are busy in the field. They have already fanned out to see where there are no committees, where is a deficiency in the committees, where there is inaction in the committees. And they are feeding back to me.
Okay, one important thing, we want on camera to know that Congress, it seems, has got lot of foreign fundings because of which you have frozen your accounts.
No, I wouldn't call them foreign funding. When funds come to a political party, there is no color. It is money, it is currency, or it is a check. Nowhere it is written that this amount which are donating to the political party, the company equity is this. Nobody says that. They just give you a donation to the party which is permissible under Income Tax Act.
Who gave you donations?
I am not aware. I was not here.
You didn't check your account?
That is an internal matter. I think the matter is judicious because there are reports in the press. I don't have any order with me, but I read in the press and I got some news on my mobile that the matter is before the court.
You have frozen your accounts.
We have not frozen our account. There is no question of freezing an account. We have not activated that account. We have opened a new account. So that account is where it is. It is not the question of freezing it. Question is that if that account is in dispute because of judicial activism and I put my funds, if at all I have some funds in that account, there is a possibility of court freezing that account and blocking my money. Therefore we say yes, this the old account of my outgoing committee is in reported dispute. I don't know whether there is a dispute. So the committee felt it because I am authorized by the executive committee to open an account and to operate an account. So the members of the executive committee felt that there are reports in the press that, you know, as everybody must have read it. So what we said, as a matter of abundant precaution, let us keep that account where it is. There's no question
of. You are not touching it.
No. Account, we will have the statement, we will see what is the balance, we will see what is the, you know, that is the internal matter, that is a technical matter.
Are you going to check the objectionable part in the entire account, objectionable money part in the entire account?
See, under the Congress Constitution, all the funds and accounts are audited. I have started my audit on the day one. I have put mechanism in place. My treasurer is here and we are recording all the expenditures we are making, receipt and expenditures, and my account will be audited. If the earlier committee is not audited, then they have flawed. They made a mistake, they should do it because the Congress constitution says so.
They have not audited.
I am not aware. My treasurer will check it and
did you check with your treasurer whether they are
audited? You know, it's an ongoing process. The things, you know, the, so many books are there, they are going through it, but this is a small internal matters which I don't know to discuss publicly. This is an internal matter of the party.
Okay, one more thing. There has been an open rebellion against you. There has been.
I don't see any rebellion. I did not even a one person came to me to say that I don't want you. Not even one person. Can you name a person who says so?
No,
nobody came to me. We had a meeting of the executive committee, and I told you the quorum because my committee is 48 member committee. I cannot please and put 2,000 people in my committee. Just impossible. We have lakhs of members in the state. And I cannot please everybody. There are 48 slots.
Others are unhappy.
Certainly.
How do you make them happy?
You give them lollipops.
What kind of?
I don't, whatever will make them happy. So, in a political party, you know, there is limits. There are limitations for this committee. Now, PCC cannot be a jumbo committee. It is a committee constituted as per the constitution. Earlier, it was, you know, everybody tried to please everybody. And there was a duplication. A person who is office bearer in a cell was also made an office bearer. It is not permitted. So, I have gone by the rule.
So, you are going by rule book?
I am going by the rule book.
Okay,
and I have also suggested to my high command, let us follow the rule book for the first time because I am in chair.
Maybe to make you speak, I'll put this question again. You are
please.
Talking about regional plan. And after scrapping regional plan, you have hurt many people within Congress party. Now, one person was Babush Monserrat.
Hurt in what way?
Because the regional plan, he was being blamed for the entire regional plan.
No, then he should clarify that he is not involved. If anybody blames anybody, he has every opportunity to clear himself that I am not involved.
I have not finished my question.
Okay,
my
please.
Question was that, do you foresee these people whom you have hurt in the past?
I have not hurt anybody. I have hurt no individual. I have pleased my people. My state people. That's all. I have no intention of hurting anybody, including an ant. If it is on the floor, I will not step on that ant. So I have no intention of hurting anybody. If in my process of doing my public duty to my people, if somebody get hurt, then that is a collateral damage. I have no intention of hurting
has
anybody.
Has anyone walked up to you from Congress and said, ki, no, you should not have taken this decision or you should not have pitched in for scrapping of regional plan then?
Sorry?
Has anyone from Congress walked up to you and said, then you should not have taken this decision of scrapping regional plan?
Nobody said that. Everybody welcomed it. The whole party welcomed it. The majority of the party, 99.9% of the party congressmen welcomed it. So, there is no question of, you know, hurting anybody.
So, right now you feel all those, including CLP members, including GPCC members, including party workers are with you, John Fernandes, as the president of Goa Congress?
They need not be with me because I cannot please them with the post in my committee. I am sorry. It is a small committee. If you want me to please them by giving them a political lollipop, I am sorry, I can't help them.
Do you feel that they are not happy only because of the post?
You ask them. I have found nobody. Nobody. My door is always open. I keep my door open so that anybody can walk to me and tell me what is his complaint. I found nobody. And when I had the first executive committee meeting, you know, it was so peaceful and it was so pleasant to transact business. And I feel at no time we had such an attendance where only 4 people were absent out of 48. 2 has taken permission and 42 attended and transacted business. They gives. I made everybody to talk. I made everybody to talk and give suggestions. And this is not my committee. It is a committee representing all the political spectrum within the Congress. Therefore, this committee is not done by me by sitting here. It is done in consultation with the High Command.
You mean to say earlier GPCC chief was not allowing people to talk?
That is not my allegation or complaint at all.
No, because you project everything is it as if it is being done for the first time that everyone was talking
that is
peacefully.
That is what my members told, who are coming from the old committee. That is what they told me, that this was most business-like meeting where everybody spoke and they gave suggestions to strengthen the party. So I was happy about it.
In In earlier tenure, it never used to happen like this.
I don't know that, but my members, who were the members of the earlier committee, the office bearers, did mention to me that the meeting was, I cast no aspersion on my predecessor, but I said that was the, you know, meeting was done in most cordial manner.
Okay, one more question.
Please.
How serious are you towards not allowing those people who have been projected as corrupt people or who have been booked under various sections of the act to get involved in Lok Sabha campaigning?
I am very, very serious about it. And not only me, whatever I have said here, Rahul ji is saying the same thing, and I am happy about it, that I am in consonance with my leadership. Whatever I have said, and also is said by my leaders, as far as the cornering of tickets in the family, as far as the new faces coming up on the political horizon, as far as fighting of corruption, when Rahul ji said that the corruption is squeezing the common man, I had been saying that throughout, not now. Even 12 years in parliament I was saying that, and I was fighting corruption, you see. So I am very happy that I have a leadership which is, you know, with a common thought.
Will you really be left with any leaders if you go on this agenda that I will not allow those person who has a tint of spot of corruption on his
I am creating new leaders. There are so many people.
What
there are so many takers
leaders?
Sorry,
what happens to old leaders?
Let them take rest. Who said that there is political continuity for eternity? Let them take rest.
There are some of them.
Let the young blood come up. Let the people see new faces. Let the people see new leadership. That is what I told my people. I am going to train you and take you up to take the position in public life. And you have to get prepared. Because now a message is given. The moment I am elected as an MLA in a constituency, I will be MLA until I die. And nobody can come up there. How you expect my Congress people, my KEDA, to have any ambition in that area?
There are some MLAs who get elected not because they are Congress party MLAs, mm-hmm. but candidates, but they are candidates. Even many a times they have contested on other tickets, mm-hmm. and they have got elected.
Very good. Costume. Then they should go up, try that, and show to the people that they don't need my party to get elected. I wish them all the best.
But don't you respect that they are so much popular in their constituency, and because of them, your party is also getting.
You're talking
popularity.
This popularity. This popularity, you go and ask people, what is the popularity in Goa? Popularity in Goa to fight election is to loot and pay the voters to get votes. That is the popularity.
You mean to say your own
MLA? I wouldn't say who they are, but this is politics in Goa. Any Goans will tell you that. And therefore, we have most of the voting population crossing the border and coming to Goa to do this business. They vote here, they go back and vote there because they make money.
Can you just have some more clarity on this, whether
no,
your own
I made a statement, I stand by it. Or on an election day in Goa, you stand at the borders and you see how many people cross over to Goa to vote just to make money. How many people are voting because they want a good governance? It is not my charge. Therefore, I have moved a bill in the parliament to make a voting mandatory. So that no person, candidate should come to you and say, come on, I'll give you money, you come to vote.
So for Lok Sabha election, there will be no use of money power from Congress?
Congress, as far as possible, will not use money where it is not required. That has been Congress, because I had been running Congress campaign from 72. I joined this Congress party in 71.
Can you separate Congress from those MLAs which are contesting on Congress tickets? Can you separate
them? In what way?
In the sense, if XYZ guy is contesting from some constituency on a Congress ticket, and if he spends money, doesn't it is also your responsibility to make sure that he doesn't spend money unnecessarily by votes?
That means he has to be popular. The very fact he is spending money, he is not popular leader, because you yourself contradicting yourself. That means he is not a leader, he is buying votes, he is not a leader.
Do you have such kind of guys in Congress party?
I wouldn't name them, you tell me.
Do you have or do you
don't? I am about to identify them and give them a rest. I am going to create a new leadership. If I find such people, I will ask them to scoot. I will bring up a new leadership. I will get leadership, you know, a young leadership which will be respected by the people. That is the only way I can put so-called app, you know, out of circulation.
Okay, one last question, because we are running two questions. First is that when you talk about giving them a rest, does it mean that next time when you are going to distribute tickets for state assembly elections, you are considering this aspect also, that if someone is really popular or he's spending money for the popularity, this aspect will be considered?
No. Money is no consideration. When you have money, you have looted money. Nobody have money because he made business and made money. You have money because you are corrupt. You have money because you have looted the public exchequer. And you have money because you are immoral. So, and people have to stone you instead of voting you.
So you are not going to give them tickets?
I will not encourage such people.
Okay.
Because there is a parasite on our society and they should be discouraged.
One last question about Lok Sabha elections, because we are running short of time.
Please, please.
When are we going to know the candidates of Congress, one? And secondly, also a sub-question, whether you are going ahead with NCP and you are giving the seat to NCP in North Goa?
Which should I answer first? When the election? In Congress, the election process starts when election is notified by the election commission, because we cannot decide something in abstract. The campaign is going on for the last 5 years. The moment a new MP is elected, the next day the campaign starts for the next election. Therefore, we have a party, otherwise we have to shut our office and we have to sit home and come after 5 years. So the campaign starts the next day a MP is elected. So that campaign is going on. Now we have a system in the Congress. We always give respect to the constitution and the rule of law. Unless election has been declared and notified,
then only the names are ready.
Shortlisting of name have started. We have been to Delhi, INCLP leader.
The final names would be only after election dates are declared.
No. When the election is notified, when the vote on account is passed in the parliament, the election commission will, make a pronouncement. After making the pronouncement, the second committee will meet. That is the working committee, the screening committee. Mr. Valer Ravi committee for us, zonal committee, that will meet. The working committee is there. The central screening committee is there.
Running short of time.
And then there is a parliamentary board.
Okay.
So then that is the time.
And what about NCP?
Decide.
Are you giving a seat for NCP?
I am told by High Command that we have to fight both the seats.
So Congress is fighting both the seats?
No, I am told by High Command, because NCP doesn't need a seat in Goa, they require votes in Goa.
Okay.
Because NCP wants to show that is a multi-state party. So they require 5% votes in Goa. They don't need a seat. They require 5% votes. If that is the motto of NCP, then we are wasting a seat. Because this North Goa seat was won by Congress on 4 occasions. So we can win the seat, because last time also when we shared the seat with NCP, we lost it by a narrow margin.
Basically Congress will go ahead, mostly Congress will go ahead.
We will have talk with ILI, we will try to adjust a seat for them in Maharashtra, because this is a BJP seat. We will give them a BJP seat and we will win over the seat.
Okay, this was John Fernandes, a highly outspoken president of Goa Congress. He says that those people who are making money and who spend money for votes will be asked to rest for next elections. But what we feel, that this can happen only if John Fernandes is allowed to continue in the chair the way he has been taking head on all the people, all the senior leadership, and most of them who are labeled as corrupt. He has said that for Lok Sabha, the names would be declared after the notification of the elections. And right now the campaign has already started for the Lok Sabha without naming a candidate. And one last important thing which he had said is that if any of the Congress leaders are against him or have to voice their dissent, the doors are open, he is open for discussions. But if someone wants to speak behind the curtains, then he can't react to those allegations, because he doesn't know their names and they have not come in public. It was a pleasure having you on the show. You are watching Hot Seat on HCN. Here we make people speak something which they have never said in past. Here we make newsmakers to speak out their heart. Keep watching HCN.